Hi, this is Danielle Morrell. I'm the Senior Director of Inbound Marketing. Today is Wednesday, July 14th, and I'm recording this video for the Inbound Marketing Group Conversation tomorrow. Our session is going to be mostly an AMA focused on the OKRs we have set for Q3 at my level, at kind of the top of the inbound marketing team. And we're going to look at how those nest under the CMO OKRs and also how we develop OKRs that then get pushed down through the inbound marketing organization. Having this conversation for two reasons. One is I'm super excited to share with you what we're planning to do to keep moving GitLab forward, but also really just wanted to share a bit more about our process, answer questions, maybe get your advice as well. So if you love OKRs or you're a great planner and you want to spread your wisdom, I hope you'll also come and help me answer the questions as they come up. So now I'll share my screen just briefly and show you what we've got. So I'm using GitLab to organize this, and this is an epic within the inbound marketing project. Just for the sake of presentation, I've written out the OKRs with links, but they're also nested underneath this epic. So as the epics and issues get created underneath my KRs, or my objectives rather, the KRs, this will all cascade down. So it's just not all set up quite yet. But we have three objectives for inbound marketing. The first is to deliver an enterprise buyer experience on about.gitlab.com. We believe that this can help increase first order large SAOs or sales accepted opportunities that are attributable to inbound, and also can increase traffic to about.gitlab.com/enterprise, which is where we're building an experience specifically for the large and public sector buyer. This nests under the CMO KR for increasing funnel volume to drive pipeline, and it also nests under the KR to deliver large expand SDR sales accepted opportunities. Next up is a complete end-to-end inbound funnel tune-up. This really has to do with tuning up the funnel in terms of both instrumentation and the actual quality of the conversion rates, all the way from the first search engine impression, all the way through to first self-service purchase or sign up to speak to sales, and ultimately to a deal closing. So we want to be able to tie dollars at the end of the funnel to the very first impressions and earliest steps. Historically, we haven't had full tracking all through the funnel, and so it makes it difficult for us to stack rank the various tactics in marketing. So this is going to help us become more capital efficient and also might identify opportunities for us to place bigger bets on tactics that are working really, really well. So some of the key results here, this one's got a lot because this is kind of, in a way, this is kind of a keep the lights on type of objective, but the thing we're doing is we're looking at the whole funnel as being in need of a tune-up. So the lens is we still need to hit the numbers, but we also want to create a new, better high watermark for kind of our base rate of traffic and inquiries. So like if we did nothing, there's sort of a baseline, and we always want to be building that baseline and then running new experiments on top to find out ways we can continue to increase that base. So some things we're looking at, there's a set of metrics around conversions, specifically inquiry to SAO rate. We want to move that by some percentage of points, and we want to look at that from a sector basis. So really trying to change the relative rate within each group, knowing that the mix isn't completely equal. We also want to increase inbound specific inquiry to SAO rate. So we really want to look at what we can control in this team, which is focused on inbound leads. So we can probably improve trial and inbound. Those are the buckets that we can affect. And there's other teams that work on the other channels. And then ultimately we do have a volume inquiry goal that we need to hit that just helps us to ultimately feed the right amount of pipeline into sales. We have the conversion rates as we know them today. So with a certain amount of volume at the top, we have, you know, growing predictability around the kind of SAOs we would see. So we also have the responsibility to kind of deliver on that foundational promise while we're also making improvements. On the traffic side, we need to continue to grow overall GitLab traffic. That's part of Project Compass. We've made a commitment to growing that 20% year over year across all the properties. But one of the improvements we're making in the way we approach this is we need to also be looking at different buckets of high value, high intent traffic. Craig calls this the hand raisers. We want to make sure the hand raisers are on a journey that's going to lead them to speaking with us, using our product. And ultimately, if they use our awesome product, spending money with us and becoming long-term customers as we continue to deliver on the digital transformation journey. So our business is very built on a land and expand motion. So that means it's so important to get people in the door, but really the way we're going to grow with them over the long term is by seeing them adopt more stages and become more committed to different parts of GitLab. So a lot of times when they adopt us, they do have other tools. And so they don't just rip and replace everything. It's usually a phased approach. And so it's very important that we be landing as much new business as possible to give us as much time as possible to grow that business. And that's really a big part of how our model is built. So some things we can do to measure how the hand raisers are doing, we need to increase about.gitlab.com referral traffic from inside the SaaS product. And the first way we're going to do that is with an MVC footer that's going to link back to our marketing site. And there's a ton of traffic going to our SaaS product. And we want to use that to drive more high intent traffic, maybe of free or low paying users, back to the site to continue to educate them further about more things we have to offer so they can begin to expand into additional stages. We also want to increase the volume of inquiries that are resulting from conversions on Docs. So Docs is incredible. Docs drives a ton of traffic. When we just look at overall traffic growth, Docs is the big driver right now. And on Docs, we do have that sign up for a free trial button in the upper right hand, which is the call to action. But we want to include other types of calls to actions that are in context with what's going on in the Docs. So certain Docs pages have different intentions. We want to make sure that we are merchandising what GitLab has to offer and how GitLab can solve problems with our paid products inside the documentation in a tasteful but useful way. And lastly, we want to get about.gitlab.com marketing site traffic growing again. So when we look at all of our properties, including the handbook and Docs and other things that are not really the marketing site, we are growing a lot. But when we look at just about.gitlab.com traffic on all those kind of pages that are an offshoot of that subdomain, the traffic is actually flat year over year. So one of our fundamental beliefs is that that traffic should definitely continue to grow. We have a lot more market we can take up. There's not a point of diminishing return that we have reached. And so through content marketing, through paid acquisition, there are many ways that we can bring more traffic to the site. And the truth is the site is just a much better website now. It's much more beautiful. It explains what we do. We've worked hard on brand messaging to move from the open message to the platform message. And all this is kind of culminating together. And it's the best time ever to send more traffic to that marketing site. So we have a beautiful asset. And now we need to make sure that the world can see it. And we also need to have more new, fresh volume of people coming through to have these conversion rates start to get tested so that we can begin to have a new bar of where we're going to improve to. And lastly, kind of to that point, this is a slightly more, I would say it's like a more tactical objective, but it's just very important that we prioritize it this quarter. So we're pumping it up to the kind of to my level as something that's deeply cross-functional. And that is we need to identify the top 20 pages by traffic and conversion and make sure the GitLab brand and message is just really beautiful, you know, kissy lips good. And this is deeply cross-functional, right? Like everyone in marketing cares about it, sales cares about it, recruiting cares about it. We want to make sure that we are putting our story forward to the world. We've worked hard to figure out the best way to tell our story. And now we need to make sure that the right people see it. So this supports the CMO objective to elevate the GitLab marketing messaging and building our positioning. So the key results are fairly tactical for this one. Identify those top 20 pages. We need to kind of create a simple score of how we're going to pick the 20 to focus on. We'll grade them on their brand imagery and messaging. That's something we'll do in partnership with the brand activation team, with Becky. We'll do this with Melissa. We'll do this with Natasha to make sure the messaging is aligning, and there's certainly other stakeholders that will be defined as needing to be consulted. And then once we do that replacement, we also need to deliver a continuous improvement plan for those pages. So these are the big high impact hand raiser pages. It's very related to the enterprise story that I was telling you about in the first objective, but this is actually deeper than that. This is our like core story. These are kind of like the 20 foundational pages that we have to have. If we had to like get rid of the rest of the marketing website tomorrow, these are the 20 pages we would always want to be making better. And so they need to be on a continuous improvement plan. So that brings you to the end of the OKRs, but not to the end of the work that's on our plates. And I think this is one of the things that often doesn't get addressed in OKR planning that is so important, which is that we have other organizational goals, other CMO or CEO level goals that we need to support, including having our team members have meaningful career development plans that they discuss with their managers, running interlock meetings to focus on prioritization, making sure that people are enjoying contribute, and then a lot of other commitments we have to other teams, including operating, you know, we have an internal kind of agency model. We're trying to really move that away from such a service model and more to a cross-functional collaboration model. We have quality and maintenance concerns around technical debt and some of the department's documentation and training, you know, gets out of date. We have teamwork to do in terms of building departments. We have hiring to do, we have backfilling to do. And then of course, next quarter's planning. So this will be the epic that I will use every day, basically in the coming quarter, to help myself keep track of where we are, figure out who's taking care of what, and hold our team both accountable and give us a way to collaborate. So I know that was probably more than I thought I could really say about a single epic, 10 minutes, but maybe that gives you a little bit of insight into what we're focusing on, how we're thinking about setting goals, the way we fit with the CMO and CEO's goals, and really just the ways that we're hoping to bring more customers to the business and support all of GitLab in getting our message out to the world. So I hope you'll come and hang out for the AMA part of this. I'm happy to answer any questions. And also just to note, like, these OKRs are still in draft form. We will finalize them at the end of July and they will be approved and on all of that, but they may adjust. So if you watch this video and then look at this later, it's possible it will have changed, but the good news is it will all be in the history of the epic. So with that, I will sign off for the evening and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow.